for the sky. Ain't gonna miss a thing, I'm gonna have my thing. I'm gonna live it till I die. The blues are lay low, they'll never stay low. They're gonna trail over my head. I'll be a devil till I'm an angel, but until then, /54 below. How are you all? Happy Pride. Oh, it's been too long. It's been too long. You know, after my Christmas show, the... Let's try that again. After my Christmas show, remember, after my Christmas show here at Feinstein/54 below, I was approached by a wealthy philanthropist, and I was offered the job of a lifetime. The kind of job every nightclub superstar, like myself, dreams of. He was at a resort on an island off the coast of Costa Rica. They spared no expense. It was a kind of a biological preserve. Play the big room, 54 million below. Dreams come true. While I was there, I had a near-death experience. The kind of harrowing near-death experience that makes you really appreciate the day-to-day things, you know. Unfortunately, because of a non-disclosure agreement I signed with the park, all I can tell you is that it involved pee as a Dora, a hot tub, a hot comb, and a hot dog. I can, however, tell you about some of my other near-death experiences that I've had with my famous character actor friends. Would you like to hear? There was that time last summer at the San Diego Zoo where I fell into the gorilla enclosure. But thank God my dear friend Terry Garr was there. And she just happened to have her tranquilizer gun in her fanny pack. Notice how the gorilla lives in my story. Or that time that Mickey Rooney and I did the ice bucket challenge on the Coney Island pier, but the force of the water and the ice just flushed us straight into the Atlantic Ocean. Thank God all those years as an extra on Baywatch really paid off. I was able to drag his liver-spotted body to shore and safety. Or that time that Ann Jillian and I were waitresses on Jabba's pleasure barge. And Dom DeLuise got so angry with me because I told him he looked gay in pants. And he kicked me overboard, right into the desert of Tatooine. Thank God Sex and the City 2 was filming there. Tax breaks, you know. So I was able to hitch a ride home and snag a Chanel bag at the same time. Or that time when I was on Jim Jay and Tammy Faye, and Jack Hanna was the guest, and he brought a seagull on, and I had a watermelon fruit roll up in my pocket, and that goddamn bird came flying at my head. I almost had the eyes of Tammy Faye. Oh, God. God. There was duck hunting with Dick. There was elder abuse with Estelle. There was spelunking with Shadow Stevens. And let's not forget about that time that I woke up in a bathtub full of ice with Jerry Orbach's eyes. About the time Sandy Duckett and I did Angel Dust. Until I die! Oh, that was fun. I need some water. Is this water? Is that a good one? What's in that? Sticky mouth. Hold on. Oh, that's so much better. Oh my God. So England, huh? I was thinking about it, and it's just so much reprinting. Just so much reprinting. What's what? A lot of what? Shut up. Oh, is that for me or is that for you? I'd rather have this one. Oh yeah, I didn't plan this part. I only wrote the beginning and then I thought, the rest will happen. And it will. Thank you for coming out and taking on Pride with me. It's gonna be a hell of a show. I think. Hey, Frank. Frank. Hey, everybody, this is Frank.
Hey, Frank.
Frank, the thing is I was just thinking, I love a piano. I love a piano. I love to hear somebody play. Upon a piano, a grand piano, it simply carries me away. And the slide trombone I thought was really divine. But today, when they play, I can kiss them. Every bar is a jar to my system. But there's one musical instrument that I call mine. I love a piano. I love a piano. I love to hear somebody play upon a piano, a grand piano. It simply carries me away. Well, you can keep your film and your phone between a P-I-E and O. Oh, 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 I love to stop right beside an upright for a high jump. Baby
again.
Oh. Both were poor choices. Oh, good Lord. I always make it to the ground. I always find the floor. I don't know if you guys have noticed, but things are getting much worse. Kind of a blanket statement, you know. It's just everything. Every time I don't even sign on to Facebook, and I've been in tears before I do it, you know. And then it's this and that and another thing, and all this stuff. But you know, I could have told you this was going to happen. I myself had a mirror into the future. I have seen Demolition Man. Light and fire and CNN keep us all abreast of breaking stories that can tend to make us anxious and depressed. Problems with no answers hang on like some chronic cold. And every day some brand new issue rears its head to piss you off. Bad guys win, optimism's wearing thin. Things are spinning out of control. Slips away. These aren't laughing matters. Time bombs tick. People keep on getting sick. And a nickel is not worth a cent. Wickedness and greed abound, just as peace is gaining ground. Hate is here to stay, and justice goes to those who pay. These aren't laughing matters. The truth is scarier by far than anything that Stephen King could write. Daily small decline and fall spelled out in black. wine. What to do? What to do? How to get a brighter view when your noodle is totally fried? Human spirits need to be leavened by a little levity. So take those blues and bounce them off the wall. Keep your humor, please. 'Cause don't you know, it's times like these when laughing matters most. Ah, ah. Shuffling rhythm. It's never coming back. Johnny was a stevedore down on the dock. He was a union man who lived by the clock. And when he up at Mary Flo, his friend said that he was bringing trouble down on his head. He didn't ask where she went, how much she spent, if she saved enough to pay the food and the rent. The one thing he demanded when he came up in the shop was supper must be on the table at 6 o'clock. One night, the supper in sight, and that's the time he knew she wasn't doing it right. Right there in the parlor, in his lover's clothes, she was playing gin rummy with the gigolo. He started to run, Johnny had a gun. He let the gigolo go, but he shot for it low. When she asked him what he'd done, and he said, "Take stock, supper must be on the table at 6 o'clock." She said, "Johnny dear, I feel mighty queer. I got an awful notion at the end of his near." The last word she heard as she lay in her cot was up. Slow side. Yeah, take it up. Let's do it one more time. Sure. You don't mind, do you? Let's see if we can do it. Song's only a minute. This will get it done in 40 seconds. Johnny was a stevedore down on the dock. He was a union man who lived by the clock. And when he got the very clock, his friend said that he was bringing trouble down on his head. He didn't ask where she went. Why he let the gigolo go, but he shot for the book. When they asked him why he done it, he told the cops, "Supper must be on the table." You know, now Johnny's in jail, he hasn't got bail. And later says tomorrow, with a smartful tale, when hubby comes home from the office for a shot, "Supper must be on the table at 6. Oh God.
What do you think you call that?
What do I call that? A song. That is called Supper on the Table at 6 o'clock. And I'm Dorothy Loudon singing it. That's how I know it. I think she sings it faster than I do. She's very good, you know. Anyways, so this next song is, people always ask me, they say, Vodka Stinger, how did you meet your husband, famous character actor Martin Mull? By the way, I'm missing two nails. One came off in the subway, and one, I don't know. We tried to give it, it's not in my shoe. Your nail ended up in my shoe once, though. It's disgusting. It did, and it was. Anyways, people always ask me, Vodka Stinger, how did you meet your gorgeous and talented husband, famous character actor Martin Mull? And I've never told anybody before. But tonight, I'd like to tell you. And this little song, it's of course in a song, because we're, you know... Yeah. And... This song is being told from my husband's point of view. So you'll have to really stretch your imagination. Imagine that. That's good. I just burped a little. All right. Go for it. Old MacDonald, he had a farm. E-I-E-I-O. And on this farm there was a chick. The prettiest chick I know. With a little curve here and a little curve there. Man, this chick, she had curves to spare. Old MacDonald had a farm, E-I-E-I-O. And oh, this chick, she had a walk, E-I-E-I-O. And how this walk would drive a walk, swinging to and fro. With a little wiggle here and a little wiggle there. Man, this chick, she had wiggles to spare. Old MacDonald had a farm, E-I-E-I-O. E-I-E-I-O. The local gentry popped their eyes. Tarnation, what a show. With a gall bang here and a gosh darn there. Them two bets got to declare. Old MacDonald had a farm. E-I-E-I-O. It was a barn man Saturday night. E-I-E-I-O. And the fellas came for miles around to see her dulce dawn. Oh, the blue mic was better at sound check. You can go ahead and start. When I first came to New York, I'm wait for the actors to come. I don't do that anymore. But I did. And I had a real affinity for a redhead. For Annie Golden. Mary Testa. Or Michelle Pach. Michelle Pach is a Tony winner. I don't think any of you are. But I can't see. Anyways. Michelle was doing Chicago, and she was playing Mama Morton, and I went 6 times. And I met her at the stage door, and she signed my playbill, which was very nice, 6 times. And then I was walking to the subway. And I thought, I wonder what train she's gonna take. So there I was on the A platform, just me and 800 New Yorkers and Michelle Pach. But there I was on 181st Street. And we took the elevator up together. She lives in a very nice building. She has a doorman. Everywhere I go, I think you ought to know I'm shadowing you. I turn around and find that half a step behind, I'm shadowing you. I love you, I would love you, except whatever I can. You see, love, what you mean, love, the indispensable man. Like I said before, I'm camping at your door, I'm shadowing you. There'll be no escape, I'm getting out of tape, and video too. In Venice, I'll be a menace in your Italian hotel. In Paris, I shall embarrass, you are the Rudy Chappelle. If you do decide to take me for a bride, the deal be done. Both of us will be so independent, we could live on the run. Making to for every cause, finding all unjust laws. Happy as can be, just you, J. Edgar Hoover, and me. Drinking again. Thinking of when you love me. Having a few. And wishing you making all right.
apart to a stranger. Just being a fool. Cause I keep hoping. For sure, I can borrow a smoke. I can sit here all night and tell these jokers some jokes. And who's gonna laugh at a broken heart? When the evening sun goes down, you may find me hanging around for the night life. Ain't no good life, but it's my life. Many people just like me, singing of old used to be. All night long, ain't no good life, but it's my life. Life is just another scene from the land of broken dreams. Oh, the night life ain't no good life, but it's my life. Oh, sure, I can borrow a smoke. I can sit here all night and tell these jokers some jokes. But who's gonna laugh? I said, who's gonna laugh at a broken heart? My heart is aching. I swear, it's breaking. And I'm drinking again. Thinking of when you love me. And I'm trying to get home, come home. But nothing. Nothing but a memory. Oh, I'm dying to get home. I'm dying to get home. And I got nothing but a bottle of beer. Just my memory.
Oh, thanks. Your name's not Wiley. What the hell's your name?
Olu. In the dark, y'all look the same to me. I like this next song. This next song is a song from the sea. Sometimes you get out on the sea, you know, and it's so dark. You can't see your hand in front of your face, you know. But there's a way to navigate, you know. By the stars. I never learned. But I love stuff about the sea. Seashells. Seahorses. C-. Stuff. I like this song. This song is telling a story from a point of view we don't usually hear. This song is, it's a spirit letting go and saying goodbye.
Skip life, a storm.
goodbyes are written by the moon and the sky. Say, nobody knows me. I got no reason to stay. Shiver me timbers, I'm sailing away. I don't know how many of you have been here before, but I'm usually flanked by two gorgeous and talented people known as the Martha Rays. This was a show that I was asked to do. How fancy. Normally I call them, or nobody calls anybody. I email them and I say, do you have any dates? And then I book them. This one they said, would you like to, actually they said we had a cancellation.
But they did say, do you want to come? You and Lorna Luft will be doing Pride. And I was like, oh, you know, Liza would be better. But... I'm just kidding. I love Lorna. I was going to be in her show earlier tonight, except that I would have had to be here like 5, 6:30 and then stay. And if you've ever been in the dressing rooms here, no. Anyway, so the Martha Rays, when I booked the show, one of our two Martha Rays was, I had booked a trip out of town. Anne, or as we like to call her, A-hole. So, and we were sad, but we did find a way to incorporate the Martha Rays into the show. Can I get Dan up here? This is Dan, everybody. I don't know a lot about him, but he seems nice, you know. Just another employee. Anyways, we do have Anne here as well. Amanda, if we could get that video, that would be spectacular.
I'm really sorry that I can't be here with you tonight. Unfortunately, as one half of the Martha Rays, I am unfortunately back in Missouri with my father instead of on the stage of 54 Below with Dan Garth. I'm sorry, Ms. Von Kastiner.
She only had one soda,
but it's important
so
that tonight we celebrate Pride Night. So please know that from Missouri, I'm celebrating with a seltzer in honor of LGBTQIACPHD. And as I'm here to do one of the most important events of the evening, which is to say, introduce what we do best, which is a medley, I'm going to talk to you about the three things that I love best about the source material, which is, of course, Mary Poppins. Number one, Dick Van Dyke's accent. I think that's obvious. Number two, gay Elsa Winchester as Katie Nana. Yeah. That's good. Number three, it's just gotta be the matter-of-fact bestiality of Jolly Holiday. The number of penguins that are sexually attracted to Mary Poppins seems unsettling as a young person. I think I'm just going to have an addendum, so if you'll indulge me, the fourth thing that I love most about Mary Poppins is schedule. At 6:01, I march through my door.
my slipper Chevy and my bar too. At 6:02, how pleasant is the life I lead.
That's true. Even though the sound of it is something quite atrocious, if you say it loud enough, you'll always sound precocious. We'd use his word and always say there goes a clever gent. Producing more harmonic rather than rather like with me.
Can't say it backwards, which was a Doge's Alley XP's to Fudgy Telly Woofers, but that's going a bit too far, don't you think? So when the cat has got your tongue, there's no need for dismay. Just summon up this word and then you've got a lot to say. But better use it carefully or it could change your life.
For example?
Yes?
One night I said it to me girl, and now me girl's me wife.
And the lovely thing she is, too. everybody hates everything and everyone. I hate normal things like my phone, because it's broken, and the buttons don't work, and the MTA, because it's broken, and the buttons don't work, and Queen Latifah, because she's just horrible. And I hate that I watched all of Lost. But unfortunately, I have now learned to hate ignorant people. Because, well, they're not here. I've curated my Facebook page to see nothing pro-gun. No idiots talking about the man with the cotton candy puff of hair. I don't want to give him any stage time. What a tiny dick. Anyways. Sometimes I also hate these sleeves. I do feel a little bit like Maleficent's grandmother. But I don't know where Dan's sitting. I only fell. I didn't even fall. I only tripped the once. No, I didn't. There's video. I tripped him. Anyways. I don't know what the solution is. And thank God nobody's looking to me for it. I can tell you, honestly, from the heart, because sometimes, oh, I missed that fingernail. Sometimes, there's power in the nail. Sometimes I just feel lost and sad and alone. That's it. I just do. I can't find my note. Can you give me the intro?
Thanks.
How touching that would have been. I could have just gone right into it. It might still be.
Before Lord God made the sea and the land, he held all the stars in the palm of his hand, and they fell through his fingers like grains of sand, and one little star alone. And the Lord God hunted through the wide night air for that little dark star in the wind down there, and he stated and promised he'd take special care so he wouldn't get lost again. Now a man don't care if the stars grow dim or if clouds blow over and darken him, so long as the Lord God watches over him. keeping track how it all goes on. Now I've been wandering through the night and the day, till my eyes get weary and my head turns gray. And sometimes I think maybe God's got the way, forgetting the promise and the words he'd said. And we're lost out here in the stars, little stars, big stars, blowing through the night. And we're lost out here in the stars, little stars, big stars, blowing through the night. And we're lost out here in the stars.
How about that, Sam? Come on. Let's do not the one that we were going to do, but the other one, and then we'll do the other thing, and then we'll do the thing. He gets it. He gets me. Can you guys take one moment to give it up for Frank Spitznagel? He's a germaphobe, and he touched me. I don't know if I'm allowed to tell people that. I'm very filthy, though. You should watch it. You have Purell. Just pass it up to him, please, quickly. Should we do the encore, and then we'll do the last song, and then we'll take a request? Why not? So this was the encore. We're going to do one song, but I think it's better to end with the song that I was going to do at last. But I want to do the encore now because it's up. Yeah. Thank you.
Yeah.
Go for it. Last summer, I did a comedy of errors in San Francisco. There was a musical break, and I was supposed to like improv with the audience, but I think the idea of that was too much for anyone to handle, because it was like, but what are you going to say? And I was like, I don't know, it's improv, you asshole. It has yet to be dictated to me. And that was scary. And so then we came up with this thing. So these two girls would come out and they'd go, ooh, I can't remember anymore. It was a long time ago. And then I would say, those are my girls, because I was a courtesan. And they were also courtesans. And so I'd say, those are my girls. I taught them everything they know. What was the next part? Oh! I taught them to always depend on the kindness of strangers. Because it took place in New Orleans. I'm telling the story very well. Anyways, one night it was raining. And I was told specifically to never change this ad lib. Because I would look at the person down front and I'd say, hey honey, is he with you? Hey honey, is he with you? And then I'd say, not for long. And the Republican San Diego crowd went nuts. You guys meant so much, but I didn't sell. And one night it was raining. And I thought I was just gonna get real cheeky and I was gonna change my outfit, though I'd been told to never change it. And so there was this really gorgeous guy down front, and I said something like, because it was a small house, because it was raining, and I said, the only small thing here is you. Which is not what I meant. But I said it anyway. You've been acting different. I've been too. I need a big hot dog on my road. What's the matter, hot papa? You gonna save your mama's soul. I need a little sugar in my bowl, and I ain't fooling. I need a little sugar in my bowl. One more time. I need a little sugar in my bowl. To wrap up the evening, and I like that. Do I get that? Is it your drug dealer? It is Gay Pride Weekend. Not that gay people do drugs, but they do. Tell them we're busy. Anyways, whenever life gets you down, Mrs. Brown, and things seem hard or tough, when people are stupid, obnoxious, or daft, and you feel that you've had quite enough, just breathe. Remember that you're standing on a planet that's evolving, revolving at 900 miles an hour. It's orbiting at 19 miles a second, so it's reckoned a sun that is the source of all our power. The sun, you and me, and all the stars that I can see are moving at a million miles a day. But out by us, it's just 3,000 light years wide. 30,000 light years from galactic central point, we go round every 200 million years. And our galaxy is only one of millions and billions in this amazing and expanding
realized that in actuality, the joke is on us. The universe itself keeps on expanding and expanding in all of the directions it can reach. As fast as it can go, the speed of light, you know. 12 million miles a minute, and that's the fastest speed there is. So remember when you're feeling very small and insecure, how amazingly unlikely is your God. And pray that there's intelligent life somewhere up in space. Cause there's bugger all down. Anything goes. What about Blow Gabriel Blow? Yeah! How does it start? Ladies and gentlemen, we're here tonight to fight the devil. Do you hear that playing? Do you know who's playing? You be ready to go when I blow my horn. Oh, blow, Gabriel, blow. No, I don't know what I'm doing. What is it?
Wait,
well, that one, that felt flat fast.
Blow, Gabriel, blow.
Join a happy band, but your name, a promised land, so blow, Gabriel, blow. Now it's clear.